All right, welcome everybody. For the purpose of this web series, my name is Joyce Geek, and I'll be your guide through the 10 100 letter words, aka thunder words, contained in James Joyce's great cryptic masterwork, Finnegan's Wake. The title of this series is Don't Panic, It's Only Finnegan's Wake. And our journey begins on page 3. It's the first page of text in all major editions of the book, and if you look down at paragraph number 3, you'll notice that word number 3 is considerably longer than the others. Now, the other stuff on this page may be difficult, but it's the initial viewing of this word in particular that causes most every neophyte to immediately snap the book shut and toss it aside with a single word, impossible. Well, to that, I have a simple one-word response. Ba-ba-ba-dal-ha-rach-ta-kami-na-rong-kon-bron-ton-a-ron-twan-thun-trovar-hun-on-skon-tu-hu-hur-den-en-thern-nook. Not so difficult after all. Each and every syllable can be understood and enunciated in a single breath as I have just done by anyone with normally functioning speech capabilities and the time to put in a little practice. So, the purpose of this tutorial is to supply a handful of tools to get you started on this truly noble endeavor. Here's the word as it would appear unhyphenated, which of course it cannot in conventional print, and I'll say it again. Ba 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 dal ha rach ta kamina rong kon bron tonaron twan thun trovar hunon skon tu hu hur den en thern nook. And one more time. Ba 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 dal ha rach ta kamina ron kon bron tonaron twan thun trovar hunon skon tu hu hur den en thern nook. So, fun! Now, the best way to get started is to break this word down into its constituent parts and digest them one by one. These syllables were not created willy-nilly by Joyce. He was very meticulous in his constructions. This will become more obvious as we move ahead, of course. Now, our first component, and repeat after me, ba-ba-ba-dal. Good. Is generally accepted by scholars and exegetes to be a reference to the Tower of Babel from the book of Genesis, chapter 11, verses 1 through 9, in which God punishes mankind's tower-building hubris by forcing everyone to speak in different languages and not understand each other. Now, actually, the Bible doesn't use the word punish, and I think Joyce may have taken note of this. Because if anything, Finnegan's Wake is a celebration of the confounding of tongues described in the Bible. And really, think about it. Why shouldn't we celebrate the fact that each of us can express ourselves and formulate our own ideas and our own individual and idiosyncratic idioms? Well, take, for example, the word thunder. Now, we all know what the phenomenon that word describes is, but isn't it amazing how many different ways we humans have of giving that concept expression? In Spanish, the word is trueno. In the Quechua language, it's cacha. In Navajo, it's iini, etc. Now, that's some serious diversity. And I specifically use the word thunder for my example because the remainder of this word that we're working on here is composed pretty much entirely of words for thunder in one language or another, no doubt to invoke on a more visceral level what the experience of thunder is actually like. And by the way, thunder word is a shorthand that we Finnegan's Wake readers most often use for these 10 100 letter words that you find in Finnegan's Wake. So, moving on to the next component, we have garakta, and repeat that, garakta. Good. Now, there are three words here, karak, gar, garahat, and in Arabic, those are in Hindi, and in Arabic we have rad, and those all mean thunder. And then the next component, kaminaron-kon, is from the Japanese word kaminari, for thunder. If you speak Greek, you know that bron comes from bronte, thunder. And then the French speakers out there will recognize tonneron as derived from tonnerre. Italian, tuon, tuono. By the way, just as a side note, a little trivia, Joyce spoke French and Italian like most native speakers would. Look at this. Speaking of native speakers, thun, there it is in English. So it's not all that hard after all. Trovar. Can you guess it? It's Portuguese. Troval for thunder. Then we have Hunanskan, which is a combination of the Swedish and one of the Irish words for thunder, aska and skan, respectively. And then I like this component, Tuhuhurdenen. Tuhuhurdenen. Good. That's from the Danish Torden, but with a bit of a stutter. And notice, of course, there's also Ba-ba-ba-dal is kind of a stuttering version of Babel. And actually, stuttering is a major theme that runs throughout Finnegan's Wake, and puts it into this thunder word twice. And perhaps the idea here is that stuttering is a natural human response to having the bejesus scared out of you by big, loud, booming noises. We conclude our word then with Tornach, another Irish word for thunder, Tornach. And by the way, I should mention here, this is a good place to mention this, the glosses that you're looking at here on the right-hand side, and you'll be seeing these in later installments as well, these are not the result of any research I personally did. Literally, hundreds of scholars and enthusiasts over the past 75 years poring over manuscripts and notebooks and letters and so on made this list of glosses possible. Their work has been compiled into a number of annotations projects, the most useful being Roland McHugh's Annotations to Finnegan's Wake, that's a print publication there, or Raphael Slepon and his amazing website, www.fuit.org. Now, be forewarned about either of these, and they're both excellent. I highly recommend them. I use both of them. Be forewarned, however, that these do have a learning curve to them. Both of them do. After all, in order to gloss all of the thousands and thousands of references in Finnegan's Wake, you have to come up with a shorthand. Otherwise, your annotations really start getting cumbersome. My point here is that learning curves are surmountable, and honestly, what more do you want? I've said this before, and I'll say it as often as I need to. Finnegan's Wake has never been more accessible than it is today. A few keystrokes, a click of the mouse, and the very thing you're looking for is right there in front of you. There's just no excuse anymore. So, I'll get off my high horse on that, and let's get back to this just marvelous, marvelous word. So now that we've done these components, what you start to do is you string them together like so. And then you practice these until you get them right. And so here we go. We'll drill you on them. Ready? Ba-ba-ba-dal harakta. Good. Kaminaron kon bron. Good. Toneron twon thun. Trovar hunonskon. Very good. Now, of course, as you might imagine, the next thing to do is just see if you can get them strung together even more. And it does take some practice to do this, but just in case you're ambitious and want to try it right now, we can do it. Ready? Ba-ba-ba-dal harachta kamina ronkon bron. Toneron twon thun trobar hunon skon. Tuhuhur denen thurnuk. And practice those together and eventually be able to say the whole thing all in one breath like so. Ba 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 dal harachta kaminaron kon bron toneron twon thun trobar hunon skon tuhuhur denen thurnuk. And that's your first thunder word. Happy practicing.